What is going on, my fellow thrash heads? So this is my second hour of Hellblade. Next time, well, I'm taking a hit for you guys, so what I'm going to have to do is play through this game 3 times. So I want to record it, right? And I'm going to stream it at times. So while I'm recording and streaming, the best I can do is 1080p. If you're watching this, please go back. Check out my video about the graphics modes. I do a little talk through and explain the power of Xbox One X. But anyway, I do a talk through of that. I did the first hour on Mixer, so it didn't look too good. But now I'm recording on my AverMedia. So I'm going to play through the game. I want to play through it in 2 modes. So I'm going to play on Enrich mode. My first playthrough, because Enrich mode, for those of you who are too lazy to go back. So watch the grass. Look at all this grass and stuff in front of me. So Enrich mode basically gives you more visual pop. More fog, more lighting effects, more shadow details. Then you have frame rate. So if you look, you saw everything disappear. Frame rate gives me 60 frames. So I'm gonna, when I go through the game the second time, I'm gonna play through on 60 frames. But right now I just wanna go with the enhanced visual. So yeah. But so far the game's great. Looks great. Ninja Theory is rocking it. I'm a fan of Ninja Theory. They've made some of my favorite games. Devil May Cry being one of them, the reboot. Oh, looks like I'm gonna have to fight in a second. If you're on the fence about this game, I mean, $30, get it. It's $30, man. Download only. I gotta get this symbol. But I'm also gonna turn up the difficulty level next time I play through, frame rate higher.
The song. Oh, no. Valravan's song. It's over here. It's over here.
Is that? It's no, it's here. There's two.
Which one?
There's two of them. It's magic. It's magic.
This reminds her of someone.
It's where?
Which forest?
So these gates right here, sometimes when you look through them, they change. Ah, there it is. So you see that?
Did she beat the darkness?
Yeah.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't.
Also, for those of you who don't know, this game does have permadeath. If you die too many times, if you go back and look at the first video, I was infected with what's called the darkness.
She nearly died.
If you die too many times, they will delete your save. You hear that eerie voice? That's what I'm following. I have surround sound headset, so I can hear that. I don't know if I can hear it.
Maybe it's Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
But where?
Some are still there.
And why?
She
no.
He's not helping.
Quiet. I can't think. Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods. She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Ay, ay, ay. Alright, clearly that ain't it.
Are you lost?
Okay. Ah, this game is so beautiful, man.
Say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learned them. Then he fell from the tree.
I gotta put the wall back. Dang, my boy wants to play Destiny. Oh, I can't turn it back. Different.
The Northmen say that Odin is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir who guarded the waters of wisdom which flowed from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own eye as offering to Mimir. He drank from a well and traded one way of seeing for another.
Hey. I miss him.
Look. Focus.
Thank you. Trying to see if I hear that guy. I kinda love that you gotta figure it out. It's frustrating, man. Alright, so
thank you.
missing something over here. I'm about to quit, yo. Hold on.
Ravens.
They will go.
No. There's three.
Where have they gone?
She did it, but what does it mean?
Looking back, it was so naive to think she could banish it on her own.
There we go.
The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all.
Alright, spoiler alert. So I was...
And the glow. I was adding these blue thingies here.
I was adding them, and I was supposed to be taking them away.
Grow in strength until they consumed her whole.
Feel my pain.
Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws.
Adding them things instead of taking them away. That's funny. Every puzzle is different. I love puzzle games.
The gate is open!
Open!
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion before her time comes?
Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keep. I know you can do it, Senua.
Alright, y'all gonna get a boss battle.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
I think I'm gonna beat this section. And I'll do a separate report.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Drew was born. Drew. The man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Oh, duh. I'm wrong. There's gotta be a way up to that middle. Oh boy, I cannot wait to fight this guy. He's pissing me off and I don't even know what he looks like. Oh, it's not letting me focus. Thank you.
Focus.
The gate is open! Open!
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
Didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
Alright, so this video won't drag on too long. I'm going to do a separate video for this boss battle. Thank you guys for watching. That was, I don't know. That was like my second stream. Third stream coming up.